Cartoonito Tales, The Nutcracker. It's Christmas Day in the Petersons' house. The Nutcracker has a brand new owner, Amy. They are playing together happily until Jake comes to spoil it. The Nutcracker doesn't like the look of him, not one bit. "That's a boy's toy," Jake says as he tries to snatch Amy's present away. He grabs hold of the Nutcracker's leg and tugs. It really hurts. The poor Nutcracker tries to be brave. Then, pop! His leg comes clean off. The Nutcracker likes Jake even less now. Jake runs away and doesn't even say sorry. But Amy is too worried to chase after him. She has to find the missing leg. But what's this? It's stuck down a mouse hole. As Amy pulls and pulls, the mouse hole grows and grows until it's big enough to fit a very small girl. Who would have thought such an ordinary house could have such an extraordinary forest hidden just behind the skirting board?
"Where am I?"
says Amy as she gazes in amazement at the sparkling snow-covered forest. Over a very curious-looking box. Amy can't resist. She peeks inside. It's not just any box. It's a dress-up box. Amy is very pleased to see the Nutcracker.
"Welcome to the Enchanted Forest," he says.
Magical creatures that live in the forest come to greet Amy. Here's the princess and the Sugar Plum Fairy. And look, here comes a dainty fairy ballerina, an elf with candy cane socks, and a very brave knight. They very kindly show Amy all the delights of the forest. Before Amy can even say thank you, magical creatures are scared away by a strange scrabbling, scratching noise. What can it be? Mice! Hundreds and hundreds of mice! Led by the evil Mouse King. And they are heading straight for Amy. Luckily, the Nutcracker knows just what to do. The Nutcracker and the brave knight battle with the mice. Despite their tiny size, the mice are strong and tough. "Hurrah!" squeaks the Mouse King.
"The Nutcracker is mine!"
It seems like all is lost when suddenly Amy remembers she's wearing her guard dog slippers. She aims one carefully at the Mouse King. It flies through the air and knocks off his crown, sending him toppling into the snow with a thud. Everyone knows mice are scared of dogs. They run away with their tails between their legs. The Nutcracker is so proud of Amy. How can it ever repay her? All the magic magical creatures in the land come out from their hiding places to thank Amy for ridding them of the evil Mouse King.
Thank you, Amy,
says the knight.
You saved us,
said the Sugar Plum Fairy. She leads Amy to the magical dress-up box and helps her pick out a beautiful princess outfit. As a very special treat for being so very brave, the Nutcracker takes Amy to his favourite place in all the world. The Sugar Plum Fairy's castle! All the magical creatures have come to celebrate. They need never be frightened of the Mouse King again. The Nutcracker feels very proud to have such a well-dressed owner. She's just missing one thing. A sparkly tiara! The Sugar Plum Fairy invites Amy and the Nutcracker to sit on the grand thrones as guests of honour. They eat the best gingerbread and mince pies in all the land and watch the most elegant dancing. Having a wonderful time. This makes the Nutcracker feel very happy indeed. No time at all before Amy has to go home. The Enchanted Forest was so beautiful, and the Sugar Plum Fairy's castle so magical, Amy feels very lucky to have found it. But in spite of all this, she's still very sad about her poor, broken Nutcracker. Where has he gone? He has disappeared! Jake has Amy's Nutcracker. What's this? He looks good as new. Amy can't believe her little brother has managed to fix her Nutcracker. She's so happy he's back in one piece again. And the Nutcracker is too.